Good morning, guys. Welcome back to the channel. If you'll notice, I'm wearing the exact same thing that I was in yesterday's video, or maybe two videos ago. I don't know. It depends on what the Jeep is feeling like in there. I got parts for the Jeep right there, as seen in the last video that I made. Again, it might have been a couple videos for y'all, I don't know yet. But the five things that I regretted doing to my truck, that video. This is actually the same day. This is like 5 minutes afterwards. So, in today's video, I'm going to be showing y'all five of my favorite modifications that I did to the white truck here. And let's get right into it, guys. Alright, guys. So, these might kind of be in order, I don't know, but let's see who can guess what the first one is. Can you guess? The first would have to be the custom paint job. The Oxford white with blue pearl paint job has to be, no doubt, 100% my favorite thing that I've done to this truck. Did that about a year ago. I did most of the paint work with the help of a family friend who is a painter, so that 100% has to be my favorite thing, number one on my list. But you know, it also come with a couple challenges. You know, I did everything, or I did most of everything, so you know, there's bad places in it and whatnot. The hood still needs repainted, but I got to get around to doing that. But that ain't no big deal. Also, another thing that I don't really care for about this paint job is, like, right now, if you look at the fender flare and the fender, they're painted right next to each other, but that one don't look like it matches the fender. That's because of the shadowing and all that kind of stuff. If you look at it right here, they look exactly the same. But if you stand back, they look different. That's the pearl and the shadowing and all that kind of stuff. That fender over there doesn't look like it matches the door. That's because the fender's kind of pushed out a little bit. But they do match. They were all painted at the same time. But anyways, my second thing, again, it is paint related. It is everything that I have color matched. This truck came factory with the color matched caps on the mirrors. We went ahead and color matched the body. I don't know if the camera's picking that up, but it is 100% matched. The cowl is 100% matched. The wiper arms are matched with the little caps, of course. My boost bars grill letter kit is matched. The bumper's matched. These are matched. My street scene bed caps, the tailgate cap, the tailgate handle, and the rear window trim is also matched right there. I like the clean look of everything being matched. You know, the handles are matched and everything. You know, that's my preference. I think it pulls everything in together and makes it look like one piece. So that's what I like about that. Again, sorry if my voice is kind of messed up. I'm still kind of sick, but it is what it is. Got to make videos, get them out for y'all to watch. Now, on to my next thing is the 7.5 FabTech kit. Like I said in one of my other videos, we're nearing the 20,000 mile mark on this lift. And it has been an amazing lift. 100% recommend it to anybody out there with a two-wheel drive 10th gen. This is the stealth kit. This is not the performance kit. This is the stealth kit. which comes with the upgraded shocks and all that kind of stuff. The stealth shocks, which are filthy. Everything's filthy under here right now. But also everything is black. I believe the performance kit, everything is kind of that baby blue color, kind of like my shirt here. But that will get matched, or that will get powder coated before very long. The rear, I don't care for that so much, but that's just me, you know. I don't like the big blocks. I wish they offered a add-a-leaf setup or a full leaf pack replacement or something. I don't like the big blocks and the U-bolts, but again, that's just me. I have a lot of issues, or I used to have a lot of issues with the U-bolts loosening up when I had the 37s. And when I pull a trailer and stuff like that, they would loosen up and rattle, so I'd have to retighten them all the time. But, you know, that's, I guess, maintenance kind of deal. So that's not Fabtech's fault. But anyways, on to my next thing, the Gen Y hitch. I got this hitch a couple months ago. I haven't had it super long, but I love this thing. Other than dragging the ground, coming through the ditch over here, it dragged, but you know, it is what it is. This is a 10-inch drop, 10,000 pound hitch. It's got the 5-position drop. And what I like about it is I can take, say I'm pulling the little trailer right there. I can take my step off, flip it around backwards, put it on the other side and still use it as a step, even though I got my trailer hooked in. Also, the adjustment. A lot of companies build drop pitches, but they're not adjustable. So, for me, I have the tiny tires on the truck, so I can set this to where I can still easily jump up here, get whatever I need, you know, whatever. Really sturdy with the step. The step is very sturdy. The hitch is, of course, very sturdy. Got a 1,000-pound tongue weight and all that kind of stuff. Gen Y did sponsor the truck, but I'm not going to lie about something just because it was discounted. That's just me, you know. One thing I don't like about it is the powder coat is kind of chipping up already, kind of fading away with the use, but that's kind of to be expected. Another thing I don't like is I had to extend my wiring because it does stick out a lot further. You know, by the time you add another hitch, it's stuck out there pretty good. But again, that is to be expected. And to kind of go along with the Gen Y hitch is my bolt locks. We're going to link those into one. The bolt locks, absolutely love my bolt locks. Again, another sponsor, but still, I'm not going to lie about something. See bolt locks right there. And one example is that, as I will tell y'all right now, my jam handles. You know those little deals right there? They sponsored the truck and gave me like 40% off or something. I don't remember now. But I never use these. I never use them. They're great. I mean, they do great. I wish they were metal. That's just me. So that way you could powder coat them or paint them or whatever. But I don't never use them, you know. I always just grab the door like I always do, like anybody else does. Unless, you know, the truck is wet or you're waxing it or something, you know. But then you could still just do this. So, you know, that's just me again. But back to the bolt locks. I love the ease of use. You know, I take my key. I would do it on camera, but you need both hands to do that. But I take my key, you know, my truck key, this one right here in my pocket, and right there, my truck key, turn it, and there it is, you know. Super easy to use, you know. You program them to your key. I will leave their link below, as well as my other sponsors are always mentioned in the description. But I have recommended bolt locks to a ton of people, and everybody that I know that has bought them absolutely loved them, as well as I do. I love the bolt locks. I have them for this truck. I have them for the blue truck. When I get another truck, I'm going to have them for that, and so on and so forth. If I plan to keep it, you know. And on to my fifth and final favorite modification that I have done is, let's see here, my powder coated K&N cold air intake. I'm actually going to move the truck, that way I can see it a little bit better. Okay guys, so that truck moves over a little bit, but just so y'all can see the intake, it was powder coated. I had that done by Booger's Toxic Toys, G2 Customs, in Morrilton, Arkansas, probably about 30-45 minutes from me, but that thing turned out killer. I love this thing. I popped the hood some. Alright guys, sorry about that. I had another GoPro battery die on me, but again, back to the intake. Right there. Like I said, I love the thing. I come out here sometimes and just pop the hood and look at it. The powder coat looks amazing. And also the intake. It's a very good intake. A very good kit. It's a K&N cold air intake. You can see. I don't know if y'all can see that. But it is a K&N cold air intake. Again, powder coated by Booger's Toxic Toys, G2 Customs, in Morrilton. But very good intake, very good powder coating by Booger. This kit, I have had this cold air intake for, man, probably 3 years, 2-3 years, something like that. Funny story, actually. I ordered this intake the day before my transmission blew up. So I had to put the transmission in before I could actually get that. And then put the transmission in, like a week later, my intake gaskets blew. So I did the intake gaskets, new coils, put that in. It's like a whole new truck. I love that intake. 100% for sure will always use K&N intakes. And it did used to have a seal on it, but I don't remember what we did with that seal. It was a wrong one or something like that, but I will get a new seal so it will seal against the hood and be a true cold air intake sometime. But I've been saying that for 2 or 3 years, so. But guys, let me open the door, get a little bit of shade for you all, for the camera. But guys, that will be all for this video. Those are my five favorite modifications that I have done to the white truck. Again, we have the custom paint job. We have all the painted accent powder, the mirrors, the cowl, the wipers, the, you know, everything. Then we have the Fabtech lift, the Gen Y hitch, and then last but not least, the K&N cold air intake. There's actually one of my old videos that I did was five things I hated about a lifted truck or something like that. Something along those lines, where I was driving around here in town And in the video, you can hear that intake whistling. Thing whistles like crazy when it's cold outside under load. But just a really good intake kit. Super nice quality and all that kind of stuff. Even for, I think it was like a $350 intake. Now, these five things that I listed are all great. And there's many more things that I absolutely love about this truck. One being my Monster built transmission. That was also, I had a local shop look through and fix a couple things with it before I put it in the truck. But that is another great modification that I did to this thing that I absolutely loved. Odyssey battery, of course. I use Odyssey battery for everything. I put an Odyssey in the Jeep. I'm actually going to have to cut the battery box to use an Odyssey, but I'm going to make it happen. My old Jeep had an Odyssey battery. The square body has an Odyssey battery. I love using Odyssey batteries. They do not sponsor me yet. I have put in a sponsor request for this YouTube channel and my other builds that I plan to do in the future. But, you know, like I said, there's a bunch of things on this truck that I have done that I love. But these are my top five that I would say. But guys, if you liked today's video, please leave a like and comment down below. Hit that subscribe button with the little bell icon. That way you get notified when I post a video. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you all have a great day.